round two of Fault, milestone one. I want to play the second game, so that means I gotta finish the first game first. So, hopefully anyone here remembers what happened last time. All I vaguely remember is we were having a great time in the bar, and yeah, we're in a very low magic place trying to get high magic. Oh wow, you both responded at the same time. Hi you two, how you doing? There's one more thing I need to do before I start. There's two more things I need to do before I start. I was trying to fiddle around with some things, and some things work better than others, such as the little counter in the bottom right there. This one should actually work with how many followers I have, unlike the other one, which didn't take into account if somebody unfollowed me. Were you in the middle of a conversation somewhere else before you, popped in here? By any chance? I don't know. I seem to be missing some of the context for that, information there. I see. Well, that's none of my business. All right, I think it's time we play a game now. Let's see. Okay, so that's definitely in the bar, and I think we saved a really good. Let's see, what did I think was good enough to save? Probably just this Faith. Face TBH. Yeah, let's go like 10 minutes into the future of the game to where we actually were. Alright, so I don't think there's really anything else. Let's see. What else do I need to remember? So, Princessy Lady, Mage Lady, Guardian of her, stranger we met at this location who is very nice and very helpful. No. It, like, I can't modify how much stuff Twitch drops you for, channel points. But if you're a subscriber, you get a bonus. Hold on, I've got a cord that's completely stuck down here that I kind of need access to right now. I don't remember the exact multipliers, but it's like, depending on what tier subscriber you are, you get like a 1.5 to 2.0 times 2 bonus or something like that. Well, if you're talking about the stream elements one, that one's been consistently 7 forever. Oh god, we got Z in here too. Great, you made it to a good game this time. Nah, it's pretty much all been good games recently. Soon though, besides the 10 minutes of Mask Shooters that I played, all right, let me try to remember who's who. Based on just vibe, that would probably be Selphine. I know that's Rune. Yes. No, there's only one thing tonight, don't worry. I just know that I have at least 2 Sakura games coming up soon. stop recommending Z visual novels until he finally plays Valhalla. That's the only way we're going to get him to start playing VNs is if he starts with a cyberpunk bartender action game. Alright, let me pick up my controller again. Actually, there's two games. Hive Swap Friend Sim is probably the other game that could get Zohar into visual novels. I don't believe you, Z. I feel like you would play that because it is Homestuck content. That's good. You weren't here when we did Skyla's route, but it was good. Ardata's was definitely meme-worthy. And Rimmel was somewhere in between the two. I gotta say, the content of this game is very different from the game I was playing approximately an hour ago. Let's just go with yes. It looks like it's at least a cloak. I don't remember if you were here the first time we played, Fault Z, but very good magic world building system and stuff as of 2 hours in, and as I'm only on chapter 2 of 8, that would make me think the game's probably about 10 hours. I mean, it looks pretty long. I wouldn't call it a cape lit. Oh yeah, that's right, we need normie clothes that don't look like they're worth like a bajillion dollars. That's like, one of the other things is like, they're from a high magic post-capitalist society, and they're then thrust into a low magic, still capitalist society. So, they wanted to get a couple of magic stones to do some magic with, and they're like, oh god, we gotta pay for this. And it's expensive and rare. I don't really remember anything else that was particularly important besides the fact that we just kind of got launched here in a desperate escape from being assassinated. I guess thinking more like they're relying much more heavily on like machinery than magic, so I did know that Kirby Amon. I did see that there was Necopara for Catboys, and I don't know how much I want to play it. I find it funny to play the regular Necopara games just because of how many horrific details there are about how cats live in that society. I'd probably want to see if it's any different for cat boys. I've heard it's not much better. So I guess I should probably put the Necopara Cafe or whatever it is on my my list. As I am actually running out of visual novels to play, because I've been getting through them at a pretty decent pace. Just as we were talking about what nice capes we had. They still look pretty good, though. They're just a little bit less jewel-encrusted. I mean, to be fair, I tell a lie. I think, I don't want to say Seraphina. That feels a little bit wrong because that's the lead character. Selphine, very close. The P-H-I-N-E was what was messing me up. Yeah, that's fair. It's 12:12 over here, but that's the perfect time to start playing visual novels, isn't it? But have a nice night. Thank you for popping in for a little bit to give me that good old... Yes, this one is safer work. This one is nothing but pure magic world building and adventuring. Though I do also play some NSFW ones with my... Here, let me show you my very funny sensor bar before you head out. We got that just in case. I don't need it for this game, but... It's always there. I mean, that's black on black's what I'm wearing. Okay, you saw a little bit of red there. There is some red. But, red and black is like basic bitch number one color combination. No, I don't think there's even lewd hand holding in this one. Or hand holding. That's for kindred spirits, or, Highway Blossom. I have too many visual novels that the titles start to run together. Oh yeah, that's right, they spell craft as VT. I was having issues with remembering Highway Blossom's name, because there's so many things. I'd believe it. It's probably pretty difficult to get something that's actually, like, dark. So, yep. I will have fun. Thank you. You know something... My sense of fashion is so outdated, it was, anytime I think I'm wearing something cool, it was probably cool like 30 years ago. Something I really just like doing is I like tying a sweatshirt or a jacket around my waist, either single or double knotting it. I'd assume it has something to do with, being able to dye something like truly black. Or really just any dark colors. Similar to purple, except the, it's a lack of pigment kind of thing. There have been replies for like a while, Toki. You have to right-click the message, which I know you don't really do often. It's not like Discord where like there's reasons to right-click something. Turns out if I... Yeah, the little curved arrow thingy. If I ever get into a world like this where black is more powerful, my wardrobe will be perfectly ready for casting spells. I had a train of thought. Imagine not being able to drink on the job in medieval times. Awful. Imagine not being able to drink on the job ever. I say. being a teacher. Imagine me just teaching a group of children a skein of beer in my hand, being like, alright buddy, what's 5 plus 7? it would be worse. It would be worse. I doubt I would be able to teach the high school students much. And I would probably be, on average, a little bit meaner to all the kids. Would it be more tolerable? There's only, like, 3 kids who I would consider intolerable. Like, 95% of my days at Mathnasium are perfectly fine. Almost all the kids are great. And, now that I'm, like, slightly higher up on the totem pole, a lot of times I can just say, like, alright, I'm gonna go over here and make some tests for some other kids. Can you deal with this child for me? And it just works. Actually, yeah, you're right. Also, I managed to get out of work early every day this week due to different reasons. First day, they're just... nobody showed up. Like, for the last half hour. So we're like, okay, there's 0 children here. So there's nothing to do. Bye! Second day, we were just kind of overscheduled. So, like, there were, like, 2 or 3 instructors when we only needed 1. So, I got out again. And then Thursday, we just straight up lost power. I started working. Like, I got in. No more than, like, 5 minutes pass, and the power goes out. We're like, okay, this is an issue. Because we don't have Wi-Fi, so we can't really do any of our online stuff. And after like half an hour, we're like, okay, this is bad. The power is not coming back. So we're just gonna close. Because there's online stuff we have to do for like every kid as they come in, and we were just kind of doing it on paper. And also, like, you don't want children to just be working on math worksheets in the dark for an hour. Not only will it strain their eyes, but also, like, nobody was paying 100% attention because they're like, ooh, dark. Ooh, rain. Oh god, that thunder nearly killed us. So I got plenty of extra time to get absolutely nothing done and rest at home. No, he's drinking again. If I'm not drunk, the clothes don't come out right. High quality black. Yep, that's kinda... that makes sense. You guys use money and have to work to live. Of course you're all tired. We're learning that the world is environmentally having issues too, huh? Now, is Outer Pole the survivable part of the non-magic place? I don't remember exactly what. Let me give you some of the nun money I have. Oh, God. Gotta read that. Hold on. Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Good thing I, don't know where that sentence is going. Wow, food, it works. Don't ask. We are quite literally half a world away of where we were planning on being. I said at least half. I said at least half, and I was right. Well, if we're on the bottom of the world, and we're trying to get to the top of the world by foot, a couple months, at best. You wanna join our party? Funny handshake, all right, fair enough. Okay, yeah. And now she cries. What a great day. Yeah. We're gonna see how big Rune's house is. She is very dodging of her personal details. Yeah, cause the lights are still on, idiot. Imagine trying to go to sleep with the lights still on. With, like, candlelight still on. Wild. Not like I couldn't do it, but I'm sure the average person has issues sleeping while there's at least four candles on in the middle of the room. on a chandelier. Mana-wise, idiot. I was rewatching just some particular big anime fights that I remember, and got the Jabril Shiritori match from No Game No Life was a lot, first off, a lot longer than I remember. I completely forgot like the middle 8 minutes of it, but it was still as good as I remember, especially for being from like episode 4. It's like 4 plus or minus 1 if I remember correctly. Just go on my Twitter, look at my replies, and it's in there. Why don't poor people simply move? Yeah, like I posted it earlier today because I was watching it earlier today. Didn't I say that? Like I was watching some of my favorite fights from Madoka Box Abnormal. Oh, fair enough. It was from 6:30, if I remember correctly. So I had dinner at my grandmother's place. I got home. I played Dona Dona for like 2 hours. I set up the stream and then I started streaming. Didn't really have much else time to tweet. Yeah, you can't reopen your mana pores. Oh, that's the mana sickness that we were talking about? Mana shock, even worse. And since the outer pole is shrinking, then that means some people just gotta live with that, which is they either concentrate towards the center of it, or they start dying. Woo, great. Back to the fights. Yeah, so I watched K's, which is when I messaged you that because Kamiya Hiroshi is K for some reason. I didn't feel like watching Takachiho's fight. I didn't watch Unzen's. I just kind of remember most of that one. I watched the finale of season 2, which I won't spoil who that fight is between. For anyone who hasn't watched it in the past 10 years. And then one other. The Kumagawa fight. Which is good. And then just going through Yozakura Quartet both seasons just to see Kotaha's fights. Because I really like characters who are summoners, as I was saying in that tweet thread. Because as I was thinking, the fight with the style users in Madoka Box are very, very good. Because for people who are not readers of Madoka Box and don't know what the fuck that means, they're basically people who fight using wordplay. I'm trying to remember, there's seven of them that are definite. Seven of them that we know to exist and we know their powers. And, like, one of them is, like, they work by using homophones. So, if two words sound the same, they can, like, basically transmute the idea through the homophone. And it's hard to give you examples because it doesn't work nearly as well in English. I'm trying to remember what the other ones were. But that one was one of my favorite ones because, like, once again, English to Japanese wordplay is hard. But it was basically the word for six stones. You could theoretically read it as the same thing as invincible. So while the character held six stones, she was invincible. And I know Nanami's basically just put the negative modifier in front of anything. So, like, dull became sharp, and, that's the only one I remember. I don't remember what the card character's deal was. I don't remember what the baby lady was besides being able to make a baby shield. But yeah, Madoka Box cool. I love the fights in it, because they're all wild. Yes, the style users are basically pun abilities. Like, I know two of them are homophones and homonyms. I don't know if the homonym one is the same one where, like, you can rearrange the radicals, which would have, if I had to explain that, I would have to go into how Japanese kanji works. I don't really want to do that. But basically, the easiest way I can explain it is, you know how if you put an R and an N together, it looks kind of like an M? It's like that, except a lot more freeform, because kanji is so much more complicated. Wonder if they'll be able to make it out of the outer pole, but in the time limit that they just set for themselves, based on, you know, their bodies. Permanently being able to leave the zone of no mana. Or low mana. Alright, done with chapter 2. Oh boy, it's Rune's father! If I remember correctly, Toki, you read all of Madoka Box, right? At some point? Oh, yeah. One of the other style users there were just... You could just make 100 of them. Like, she could clone herself up to 100 times, and any of her clones could take on the form of someone else. Okay, so would you mind going into the style users of the Madoka Box wiki and finding the one that looks like the nurse? And just figure out what her ability was? Or, like, what her style thing was? Because I don't remember if it was a pun... I don't think it... Maybe not all styles were puns, pun-based. Because I think it was, like, as long as you could hear her singing, or the closer you got to her, the younger you became. Which is how she made the baby shield. but I feel like there was more, something more specific to it than that. Does it say anything more specific than manipulating nursery rhymes? So I was close. I thought I was lullabies, not nursery rhymes. Maybe in the trivia section. Rudo Jebbets. Oh yeah, the fact that so she is a robot. Oh god. Yeah. That is entirely what the baby shield was. Okay, fair enough. It was proximity based too. Like the closer you got, the younger you got. Cause I remember it was like middle school Madoka in the vents trying to be like, what do I do? then there was the tiny card girl who could trap you in cards. I don't remember how that was related to words, but, whatever. There was the homophone lady on the plane. There was the homonym lady, who I don't remember anything about that fight. There was Namine. Okay. So this guy is the CEO of a company who created Rune, who I'm fairly certain is a robot, or something of that like. And it was vaguely hinted at that at some point, or like, you know, that she's not normal, based on like the 7 different times when Rune's like, hey, would you like to know about me? I think not. We have... He got too distracted by Ratona's eyes to give us a straight answer on that one, so we'll figure that out in like the next 10 minutes, probably. I still think I'm missing one of the style users. There was the one who fought on the plane, there was the mechanic person they fought after landing, there's Namine. Was Kotobuki style user? I think so. Yeah, it was definitely Jet Black Wedding Arc. And then there was the Shiritori game in which I'm trying to remember if I can remember all the rules off the top of my head, but it's you can't use the same syllable. Like you can only use each syllable once. You have to answer after exactly 1 hour, so you can't answer early either. I think those were the main two things. And then just your standard Shidori rules. Yeah, no. It, and also calling it a different name. As I said, this is the CEO of the company that created her. Contradictory conjunction, that's Namine's ability. 800 lies is the copy person. Wait, hold on, I'm missing someone. Testament is the father's ability, which, I believe the specific wording of the ability is, if the user dies, the moon falls on the planet. Provocation is Fukuro's ability. Misconversion's the homonym. Metonymy, I'm off by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Provocation is Fukuro Tsurobami's. The sun. Wrong. Interesting. Who? Or do I have the names wrong of, Oh, okay, so Fukuro Suru, it's Hato something. Kamome. I got the name switched. I knew they were both birds. I didn't remember which one's which. Fukuro is the Testament user then, right? Oh, me. Hmm. Can you say what that one is? Because I don't remember that ability. Oh, okay. That's why my count was wrong. Because one person had multiple. Okay, so he did have Testament. Okay, thank you. Hold on. Okay, now I gotta count again. Hold on. So. Ah! I'm on the wrong screen. Okay, so let's see. So, Kanji, Label, and Mio. Hold on. Misconversion, Miyoteni, Label, Kanji. Oh, no! That's because he had all of the style abilities, and then he gave them out to others. If I remember correctly. Because the 800 Lies user used Miyoteni, I believe, at some point after he gave it out. Because at least five of those have to be the bride characters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's 9, which means 4 of them are not bride characters. And I know Provocation is, Kamome. Oh wow, Sarah was steal- or sorry, no, preferred name. Rune was stealing sediment for you guys. I forget, is class 4 the high class or the low class? Now I'm confused. Okay, yeah. Now the slave, you idiot. okay, that's funny. Alright, so what's the... What are you gonna pay me? With sediment? Oh yeah, okay, fair enough. Okay, class 1's the good shit. Good. No. Jag. Let's just kinda... Yeah, cause... It... Still thinking about Madoka Box, but, I mean... Is... What's worse, slavery? Or creating beings who will work for... Or creating golems who will work for you? It depends on how smart they get. It's the AI issue. If you make AI that's smart enough to have its own conscious, how are you supposed to treat it? I actually did an entire project in one of my English classes in college about this. Yeah, our project was, hey, what would happen, it was speculative future stuff, and we were supposed to make a poster that was pro, future thing and anti-future thing, and, me and my partner were like, AI, having enough consciousness to have people argue whether or not they should have rights. I made the one where the robots do have rights, and my partner made the one where they're not, where they don't have rights, or like people arguing that they shouldn't have rights. And it was, don't worry, it wasn't because they thought that robots shouldn't have rights in the future. It's just we had to do it, and They were cool taking the anti side. Oh no, we've said the illegal words. You know, that Oh yeah, that, I hate that. Once again, theoretically... There are ethical things to argue about that. I just don't like either option there. Alright, now I just really want to read Madoka Box again. not the Unknown Shiranui arc, though. I will... I will just read... Let's see, Yes, I agree. Theoretically, they are more ethical than human soldiers. But... Alright, thank you, Toki. Hold on, let me see if I can do it. Student Council Arc. Flask Plan. Minus Arc. This is where the timeline gets funky for me in Modok, but I don't quite remember the order after that. I want to say... Successor Arc... I'm missing one. Because then I'm hitting Jet Black next. And I feel like it's too early for Jet Black. It's Jet Black Wedding, or Bride, or whatever. Unknown Shiranui, and then Heritage to the Future. And I'm pretty sure there's 8 arcs. Though I think I did get the order right. There's one or two that I could have messed up in there. Hey, it's reformist punishment. Not a punitive punishment. I'm trying to remember if there's just any characters that I'm forgetting. What are the important characters of the arc that I'm missing? Yeah, UBRB. I'm just gonna think more about Madoka Box as I usually do. It's not like the 8 figures up there specifically all positioned so that like they fit in the in my screen work. Yeah, please do. I also feel like I get Heritage to the Future and like the Successors. I just mess up the naming there. Also, like the arc that's after Unknown Shiranui, barely an arc. I think that's why I sometimes get messed up whether there's 7 or 8, because I don't know whether to count that one. And then there's post season, just the Kumagawa being a jag. Good Loser Kumagawa, that's the name of it. I wonder if you could just like jump in and out of the outer pole and just it should be because they said like it's your body getting used to not having enough mana. So like if you just come in and out. Okay, here, let's see. Student Council, 13 priority, that's what I called Flask Plan. Kumagawa, that's the minus arc. Madoka's Successor, got that one right. Jet Black, the forbidden one that we ignore. But oh, Bouquet Toss to the Future, that's the name of it. Not Heritage to the Future. Okay. So I did actually, and I wouldn't consider Epilogue an arc, it's one chapter. So hold on, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so it's 7. Plus, they're also counting the epilogue chapter and Good Loser Kumagawa, which is a prequel. So cool, I got all of them. I couldn't think of any characters or arcs that I was missed, like any plot beats that I was missing. So that's why I was confused. Unfortunately, we don't have Zohar here to just be like, hey, you want to know what all this is about so that you read it after I made you watch the first season? So I guess I count 8, including Good Loser Kumagawa, which is what the extra was. Because I personally don't count the epilogue as an arc. It's just the good end where it's like, alright, everybody, the powers were all... Actually, you know, let me not spoil that, but let me just say... Madoka gets her one wish in the future. In the epilogue chapter. Her one true wish. No, not that one. The one where she can pet a dog. It took her 200 chapters to be able to pet a dog. That I'm okay with spoiling. Oh wait, ho, yo, we got a interaction. can't use my controller. I gotta use the mouse for it. Oh god, I have disconnect. Oh god, everything's... I lagged out the computer by taking 6 screenshots all at once. Yeah, all of the characters have their epilogue thing, like, Shiranui eats some meat. Kay becomes a demon slayer. And remember, kids, there's at least 2 characters who have preferred names in Madoka Box, so use their right names, otherwise I'll come and get ya. And force you to read the whole thing again until you get it right. Now, I know I remember both of those characters and their preferred names. Now, do you remember them, Toki? Nope. Can you remember either of them? Not in the slightest. I'll give you a hint. I'll give you a hint for each one. One of them was animated, and the other one is Kay's sister. Now do you remember their names? Did I? It's first 2 arcs. So, Flask Plan arc. Does that dot dot mean you're trying real hard to remember who that is, or... Yeah, Shoryu Onizuka. Nope, you're right. I don't really remember her deal besides also being a little weapons happy and, having an eye patch. Wait. I think both of the preferred names characters have eye patches. That might help. Or at least if not eye patch, but you only have access to one of their eyes. No violence, but maybe we can get a little close. The other one is Nazeyoka, if you're still struggling on that. Wasn't there a class 13 character with, like, a visor? Were there any abnormals with visors? Bandages? Yeah, that's Naze. You're thinking of the exact character that I was trying to get you to figure out. Her entire head was pretty darn wrapped up. Good job. She's got a knife stuck in her head. Now see, the true Madoka Box fan challenge is being able to name all 100 characters. Oh, technically it's 101, I think. Because in the future thing, what's it? I forget the actual name. In Bouquet Toss to the Future, there are 100 cards that Madoka received from every single character in the show, except, you know, Madoka herself. Yes, Naze is Madoka's sister. I think younger, though, if I remember correctly. No, it might be older. I know Maguro's definitely the older brother. I don't remember if Naze or Madoka. It would make sense if Madoka was younger because she wasn't at the school as much. Naze was already at the school when Madoka joined. Yeah, class 13 was... Well, there... Naze is technically class 13, but it's weird, because there's class 13, and then there's, like, the 13 party. Which, I think that's the name of the arc, right? Yeah, 13 party. Which is, of course, made up of six characters. There's the top six, and then there's the plus six. And then there's Unzen, who was there and then left it by the time we were introduced to the fact that there were 13 of them. So there were really only 12. So let's see. I don't think I can do all the 13 party by name, mostly because I forget what Rabbit Kid's name was. But, code name like Snow Rabbit or something. There was Odo Mikan's really long last name that I don't remember. Takachiho. Murakata Kei. Itami Koga and Naze Yoka. I don't remember, like. So, and then the plus six was Hera Lady, Spicy Boy, Person Who Ate Bullets, who had only one scene and I really liked her, it's like Otome Yunomae or something like that. It's the character that's on my oh god, did I actually get her name right? That's wild. Or was I close enough that you counted it? Oh my god. My brain's messed up. And my name order for Madoka Box is my name order is shot. I don't know which one's their first name or last name. Because however I read it or watched it, they either swapped it around or they kept it regular. And I could never remember who anyone was. Besides, like, characters with siblings. So, like, I know Madoka Kurakami, Maguro Kurakami, Father Kurakami. Kurakami's the family name. Emukai, one of the minuses. Let's see. I have all the minuses too from Minus Arc. Because that was a 5v5. It was Kumagawa first. Can I do that order though? I don't think so. Emukai. I know she was versus Zenki. No, not versus Zenki. Hold on, I'm confused. Because I know Zenkichi fought Emukai. But I also feel like he fought Kumagawa, and that doesn't make sense. Because I'm pretty sure it was 5 1v1s. And it was Madaka, Zenkichi, I want to say Akuna, Kikajima, and Hinokage versus Kumagawa, Imakai, Shibuki, Shiranui, and Redirecty Boy. I know that I must have on average slightly higher knowledge of Madoka Box characters than your average person, because I remember Royal Hirado and Gorgeous Hirado, and literally nobody ever remembers those two. I've been talking about Madoka Box for a good 10 minutes, it looks like. So, I don't remember which one's which. One of them's class 13 first year, one of them's class 13 like third year. One of them fights Madaka like in between the Minus arc and the Flask Clan arc. I should have said that in the other order because that's right. And then the other one is like in a singular cutscene before the epilogue, but after Unknown Shiranui, I believe. Just like Madaka beat up a bunch of people. It happened. They just wanted to fight. No. It must have been one in between student council and one in between student council and Flask Clan, and then one in between Flask Clan and Minus Arc. And if you just want the names, it's I believe that should be the exact name of both of them. I believe they were both like, one definitely had like bandaged eyes. They both had funky weapons. Like, I think one was like, stop sign kind of thing. Maybe even both of them had something like, they both had a sign or something. Oh, I guess there's technically, yeah, she showed up for a panel. I think they both showed up for like no more than a page, if not more than a panel. So there's more than 101 characters, because there's also the characters introduced in the, okay, so. So Royal was the one who shows up in between Student Council and Flask Clan. She's in like episode 1 then, I guess, at the end of season 2. The second appearance, or I guess the third appearance, is definitely the fight, because Madoka fought literally everyone in Bouquet Toss of the Future over the course of like 2 chapters. Maybe no more than 5. I don't remember if there was, I want to say it's closer to like 2 chapters. Because one was like her fighting everyone, and the other one was like her being like, ah, that was good, that was fun. And then having the giant thank you letter spelled out from everyone's notes together. So let me try to think. If I add, how many characters are only in Good Loser Kumagawa arc? Pretty much everyone besides Kumagawa, because it's just a separate school, and this was before he transferred. So there's Saki Tsukinosaki, who's the vice president. Vice president after they take over. I don't remember Air Bike Lady's name. I feel like it's Jogasaki something, but that feels wrong. Like, I feel like it's right, but I also feel like it's wrong. And I do believe air bike... Sorry that I'm just, like, spewing facts about Madoka Box for about 2 hours while slowly going through world building of this place. It's technically a lot more tech than okay. It is Magitech. It's a lot more tech because there's basically no magic in this location of the world. So, yeah. Also, maybe if I talk about Madoka Box for long enough, I'll get, like, one or two more people to read it. Now, see, Zohar, if you liked Season 1, but not, like, the first half of Season 1, but, like, the last two episodes of Season 1, where it was more like a battle thing, then, you'd like the second arc of Madoka Box, because that's, like, mostly battle. And then, if that's not your style, you should hit Arc 3. Which is kind of battle-y, but it starts moving to more, like, some of the more wild stuff, and, because we start having the Minuses, who are absolutely bad at doing things. They're the opposite of the abnormals and specials, who are good at doing things. Minuses, they just suck. They can't do shit. You did enjoy it, wonderful. I'm glad I forced you to watch Season 1. Now watch Season 2 and or read it. I swear, it's 200 chapters of pure goodness. What genre do you like? I bet it's in Madoka Box at some point. Which do I recommend? Like, the anime follows the manga well enough that I would say, and like, it looks real good. So unless you are... There are two main reasons why I would suggest not, two main reasons why I would suggest not watching the anime. One, you don't feel like putting in another 6 hours to watch it, which I'm okay with. People, you can only watch so many things. Second reason, if the fact that the eyes are always drawn over the hair, and, like, hair going in front of a character's face, the eyes are just on top of that, if that weirds you out, that's okay, I understand. It is a little... it's weird. Okay, Toki, you're right, but also, read it because the Minus Arc also wasn't animated. Like, Minus Arc is Arc 3, and I'm not saying it's the best arc, but it's definitely top 2 with Jet Black Bride. Arcs 3 and 5 are my two favorite. And neither of them were animated. But, like, you can just watch the first two seasons and then start at, like, chapter 40-ish. That's fair, yeah. Imagine all of Madoka Box being out when you read it. it was literally, like... it was literally, like, one of the first manga that I read fully, like, in order. And also, like, one of my very early anime... And I still hold that it is incredible. High Rise Invasion, another 200 chapter thing. Didn't you say give me something long to read so that I can read it on a plane or something? Or like while you were traveling? So, like, there was reason for you to reading that all in one sitting. Because I recommended it to you because it was long. Oh, the night before fi- oh, okay, sorry. But that- yeah, High Rise Invasion, also pretty good. Now see, that one's like the opposite of Madoka Box for time commitment. Because that's like 220 chapters. But the Netflix anime that they released like earlier this year, I'm fairly certain it covers the whole thing. Which I don't understand how they do that in 12 episodes, and I haven't watched more than the first episode yet. But like, based on the episode titles, I think they covered everything. It's like the opposite of like Dragon Ball Z and One Piece, where one chapter. Thank you for that reaction. Like Dragon Ball Z, you can one battle that took place over 5 pages, that'll be like 5 episodes. Versus apparently whatever they did to Tenku Shinpan. Like They dropped it Netflix style, which really dropped my motivation to watch it all. So like they dropped all the whole series in one day, and I'm like, nah. A fully dubbed and subbed, if I remember correctly, too. So if you so depending on how good the adaptation is. Yes. Like, I can theoretically... Yeah, like, each chapter is a lot, but, like, there's a lot of stuff that I'm fairly certain you can just kind of cut. Like, if you just do, like... And, okay, also, first episode was, like, no more than 2 chapters. Because it ends with meeting Nisei, so that's no more than 5 chapters in. Because if I remember correctly, like, it's chapter 1, policeman chapter, and then, like, no more... Yeah, I would say probably 1 or 2 more chapters, so, like, they hit hard max 5 for the first one. So, like, meet Nisei, mask, Rion, sniper, brother, yeah, that's gonna be real hard, spicy guy, great angel, like, I'm just naming important characters that are basically one episode's worth of important content. Oh, yeah, because there was also, first episode also had... Yeah, first episode was probably 4 to 5, because I forgot they also did Maid Mask in episode 1. So, you know, reasonable, if they kept up the same pace as the first episode, they should have gotten through, what, like 60 chapters? But I feel like it would get harder as you went on, because it starts getting a lot denser and, like, more than just, oh god, we're on top of a building, and, there's a bunch of guys in masks trying to kill us. But, to be fair, there are a lot of scenes that are just, oh god, it's a new guy in a mask trying to kill us with, like, a baseball. Alright, so quick plot summary to get Zohar interested in High Rise Invasion also. Zohar, we're gonna force you to watch all the good stuff, or read, whichever one you prefer. Main character gets isekai'd into a world where you're on the top of a bunch of skyscrapers. The entire world is just a bunch of the top of skyscrapers, all connected by these... yeah, sorry. By, like, these, very, very thin, very spooky bridges. There's a bunch of people with masks who are trying to, what's at the bottom? You can't go down, like... yeah, I know. But at least the two content providers are trying to push the same content. So you can't descend... Oh, okay, that's fair. You can't descend more than, like, a floor or two down most of the skyscrapers. You have to travel, like, between the bridges. And it's mostly fenced, but there's some very convenient gaps, where if you don't want to be in the isekai skyscraper world, you can simply go down off the side of the building. Yeah, so also, content warning, suicide, there's a lot of it. It's kind of one of the main points of the show. And there's a lot of cool things that just happen, like, how the world works. Like, it's a very sturdily built world. And, yeah, thank you. Like, that one's definitely one where, like, just read a couple chapters, and if you're vibing with it, keep going. But if it's, like, if it's either too much or just kind of weird, get rid of it. Which, you know... that's generally how I recommend anything. It's like... Toki, that's your own fault. For, like, multiple different reasons. Okay, so apparently Rudo made a golem. And his golem's taking his little sister's thing. Toki, I know at least one thing you've done wrong, which is that one math test where you got a 17. You did so much math incorrectly on that test. You were at least 83% incorrect. It was a strat... the strat to get better at it so that you could get an A on it after freshman forgiveness. Fair enough. You didn't want to take, like... If you wanted Galaxy Brain, you should have just taken Environmental Science, the space one. I don't remember what it's called. Okay, now that I'm done shoving for High-Rise Invasion... Alright, Toki, hit me with some more Madoka, I don't know, questions? I don't know... What's something else in Madoka Box that we haven't talked about yet? Or, you know... I'm feeling like... well... Jujika Hachina... Hachinin Katake? I don't... I can't read that. It's 10-something, 100-people-something. My guess is... it's that... a character I... ah, no. I can't remember all 101 important characters on site. Oh, shoot, I forgot about another 5. The alternate 5, The grooms. She has the teeth. Which teeth? There's so many teeth. Are you talking spiky teeth like Saki Tsukinosaki, or... you, Yeah, okay, she's another Shark Teeth character. All right. Give me... Can you give me a little bit more context of where she is? Because I truly do not know where she could be from. Also, the names of all the characters in Madoka Box are crazy and funny. Volume 16, chapter 132. They're all in the epilogue. If they went to the school, they're in the epilogue. Volume 16, chapter 132. I would... Jet Black Bride is... I know that's the long one, and I know Unknown Shiranui has some meat to it, so I would assume that comes during Jet Black, because I don't think Successor... Like, the first four arcs would... The first four arcs, I think, are the first 100-ish chapters. Maybe, like, 110, 120-ish. And then the... Jet Black is, like, a good, like, Successor. Yeah, that's what I thought. No, I was wrong. Successor's, later. Huh. Was... My timing's off, then. How does Successor go that... I guess if Minus Arc was bigger than I remember it being? Is she one of the Successors, or is she one of the Teachers? Or is she just some other character? Neither? Okay, fair enough. Class 13 character that I don't remember? Are you just looking for people with funny names? Because that's all of Madoka Box characters. They're either puns, animals, or just funny. Alright, give me the plot synopsis of what she did in those four panels. She sung. Is she one of the people who ends up in the band with Saki then? Okay. You say one word about the plot synopsis and I remember who it is. Hey, remember how Kumagawa gave a great speech? Being like, hey guys, remember, if you ever feel bad and horrible about yourself, just remember me, because I am guaranteed to be worse. There is not one single thing that I or that you can do that I can do. If you wake up, pour some ketchup into your cereal, and it catches on fire, you just gotta remember, my breakfast was worse. So if you're ever feeling that down, just remember. And also, if I no, I don't remember correctly, so I'm gonna not say that sentence. That was during the graduation ceremony, versus in Good Loser Kumagawa. This is the saddest thing you've ever heard. Okay, but Zohar, Kumagawa, his self-confidence is literally negative, but like it's a boon to him. Just trust me on that. Oh, so just I'm trying to remember. So Kumagawa has two abilities. Kumagawa's ability is he just can undo. Okay, not one of his abilities, because he's got like three. The main ability that he has, or at least when we're first introduced to him, is All Fiction, in which he can declare something to be fake and just get rid of it. So, like, this ability literally makes him immortal because it auto-procs on his death and is like, okay, yeah, so whatever killed him didn't happen. And I know he started with 100 gauntlets, and then Anshinin gave him, thank you, you gave me a topic to start talking about again. He had 100 gauntlets. Anshinin yoinked it, and gave him All Fiction instead. And then afterwards, he kind of fused the two. But yeah, he's very bad at doing things. He's got a record of 0 straight wins in any fight he's ever been in, but the opponent usually loses by even worse. So it's really bad. So Good Loser Kumagawa is like, it's a side story to Madoka Box. But one chapter of the 2 or 3 got adapted into the anime as season 2 episode 12. So if you just want to watch season 2 episode 12, you can do that because it's a complete side story. I wouldn't just, but like, on one hand, you can't really do his fight against artist guy like Ezuke or something. Like, you can do it. It doesn't make as much... Like, it was in the manga first. But it's better in the anime. Trust me. I don't want to spoil too much things, because if you're actually interested in reading this, like... I don't want to spoil too much. If you've got any particular, things that you are okay with being spoiled with, or really don't want spoiled. Yeah, Blank, kind of his deal. Because I know when I'm talking with, like, Nandan or other people about games and such, like, I don't want plot spoilers, but, like, I'm okay with, like, gameplay spoilers, and I know Nano doesn't want to know anything. Like, he doesn't want to know how the game plays. I'm like, no, tell me how the game plays. Tell me any funky, like, combination attacks that I will never learn about naturally. But, like, if you're cool with us just talking about random plot points far in the future, I will keep doing it. Or I can just stick to random side character trivia. Or just other random trivia. Yes, Toki? Do I remember how old Anshinin is? I believe 600-ish. Either that, or she was fighting Guy for 600. Okay, if you're only partially following, great. Just feel the amount of emotion that someone who really, like, there's absolutely no way that I would be able to remember all of this if I didn't like the series, and I wouldn't have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 figures up there from the series out of, like, the 11 that exist if I didn't like the series. So you know that it's good enough for me to be, and I also own all of the manga that I bought in Japan. So yes, I like the series. I will talk about it forever if you let me, and I have let me. Now, if you were to ask me how many abilities Anshinin had, I sadly know it's closer to the number of skills she has, which, yeah, I was about to start talking about that. I used to have the number memorized. So 600 years is how long she's been fighting Ihiko, right? Then, right? Or that's how old Ihiko is. So Anshinin's like 3 trillion? No, quadrillion. It's quadrillion, isn't it? It's like 3 quadrillion, 142 trillion. Actually, wait, no, that's just pi, isn't it? Wait, is her number of skills just pi? I don't quite remember the split of her abilities either, because I know her abilities are split between... Yeah, go ahead, post the numbers. Because it's... split into minuses and abnormalities, with, I believe, abnormalities skewed at like a ratio of 2 to something. Ah, 402, not 142. I was fairly darn close. Oh my god. Oh, the age is the 3 quadrillion? Wait, hold on. 100, 1,000, million, billion. Oh, age is 3. So it's 12 quadrillion abilities. 3 trillion ability. Age. So I got her age and amount of abilities switched. Also, isn't it kind of spooky how I remember the exact, basically, a good enough ratio for the abnormality and the minuses? Oh, you know what the 600 is? The 600 is how many moves she used against the grooms in the beginning of Jet Black Bride. If I remember correctly, it's 614. Without count up, and then it hits 615 after she uses the skill to count skills. Oh, you're making the noises that All right, Toki. What is it? I'm fairly certain it was slightly off of 600, wasn't it? I could have sworn it was 600 and change. I think if you check that chapter, she does say exactly how many skills she uses. Thank you. Oh, Ratona drinks too neat. I do actually, she was drinking in the bar, I remember that. Yeah, to be fair, the reason why I remember that it's 600 is it's because it's 6 suitors, and she uses about 100 per, which is just, the entire page is, like, there's an entire page of her beating each character, and it just lists all the skills she uses. I wouldn't be able to say, how much she used per page, because I don't think it's exactly 100 on each one, because if I remember correctly, the magic one, was a little bit higher than the other ones. Let me play the fun game of can I remember all of the types of skills, because it was, one was like weapons, one was like martial, one was magic, one was like natural, or like think monstrous abilities, like D&D monstrous abilities kind of stuff. Maybe like one was probably like okay, so like it was like one was fist fighting, one was like melee weapons, one was like sharpshooting, natural, magic, and I'm forgetting one. Were there six tutors? Am I just forgetting one? That would make more sense with the amount of, with the number of styles there were, because that would mean that there was Yeah, so I think that makes sense. Thinking about it, because there that means that there's seven style users who aren't the dad, because the dad had two. He had his offensive style and he had his don't drop the moon on Earth style. And as being the creator of all the styles, he did have access to all the ones that he gave to each of the suitors. Or, wait, was Kamome considered the sixth one? Was it five girls in Kamome? Also, great thing about the Jedi Black Bride arc was he was gay. I have mixed feelings about Short Hair Madoka. Mostly because Nishio Ishin does that to all of his main characters. And I love when either short hair characters get long hair or long hair characters get short hair. He does it every single time. And sometimes I just really like it when they have a lot of hair. Like, when Togame lost her hair in Katana Gatari, I was miffed. That hair reached the floor, literally. Like, and beyond when her hair was let down. There you go. It should be pretty easy to find in the chapter. It's like the page after, or maybe two pages after, the six pages where she goes buck wild, as you say. Can you tell me which type of skill I'm missing? Because I'm pretty sure it's fisticuffs, sword, gun, natural weapon, magic, and something else. Or is like there was one where like the image is kind of poisony looking. Is that not the natural one, and I'm mixing together two of them? Because I think there's also one that's like kind of dragon-y. If you wanna give us your collection of like some of the great skills you can see in there. Oh, bio skills. Okay, so bio is the natural ones, and boss skills. Huh. Sword, martial arts, magic, mental. Oh, so there wasn't a gun one. And I wasn't sure if it was all sword or just, like, melee. So sword, martial, magic, mental, bio, and boss. So I think boss is the one that looked like the dragon, right? And then bio is the one that looked like poison. Make consciousness non-existent. It knocks you right out. So mental's the one that I forgot, like, completely. And I added one extra weapon one. Yeah, simply transmute to fish. It's nice that we keep saying stupid things to at least the nice people. So when we say something stupid to like, or so that we don't say something stupid to someone who'll be like, all right, time to kill you. Remember, Anshinen can give skills. So, you know, hit her up for that one if you need it. Now, is that a mental skill or is that a bio skill? That's a boss skill! I vaguely remember If it's not on the wiki, that's weird, but because I read that, like, it says she uses 100 of each skills, but, like, somebody's actually went through and counted it, and they're like, yeah, there's not exactly 100 on each page. Maybe I just... I will go and count it up for me if I must, but, also, to whoever translated all 600 of those skills, thank you. I gotta know what the Raws for that looked like. I'm guessing it's stupid kanji with even dumber furigana. Somebody had to translate all of that and then format it all so that it still fit on reasonably the exact same amount of space. And given Japanese and English don't always take up the same amount of space per word, that can be very difficult. Though it might have just averaged to be similar. And there's also probably some stuff that you could just cut out if necessary. But like if it's as I expect it to look like, I would assume it's pretty hard getting that all to fit in English. Ooh. Colored man. Oh yeah, the... Yeah, with their extractors and such. Are you still on boss skills, or have you made it back to the mental skills? Okay, that makes sense. Rune was the what? Why is Rune using that name? Yeah, I know a lot of those skills are definitely really useful. Like, I think it's on the martial arts one, but like she's got multiple skills that are like make a hit multiple times, or like one hit instant kill thing. So, like, there's a lot of skills that don't need to be, activated at the same time. If I remember correctly, once again, because I'm not always correct about all the things that I have memorized, but I do have a lot of things memorized about this series, the six fake suitors, they all specifically, like, mentioned their fetishes as part of their character introduction, and whatever it was very related to the actual... the bride who they were faking in for. Sarah? Question mark? Rune? Question mark? You know, sometimes I just gotta do it. Sometimes I just gotta make sure that everybody knows what my favorite series is. I definitely have not progressed through the story as quickly as possible, but I think I, like, if I talk about Madoka Box for 8 hours, I should have the entirety of Fault Milestone 1 completed, given the speed at which I've been getting through this. Because I got through, like, half of Chapter 2, all of Chapter 3, and we're somewhere into 4 at the moment. Yeah, once I started talking about anime battles and just the fact that I remembered Madoka Box, I decided I'm going to talk about Madoka Box for the rest of today. And you know what? I pretty much did. Not really, like... I do think I've got a pretty good grasp on what's been going on so far. Like... Chapter 1, introduction. Chapter 2, having fun at the tavern. Chapter 3, uh-oh, CEO dad. Chapter 4, what is Rune? Oh, also part 3, cool shirt. Cool cloak. Man, the issue is, I remember so many bits and pieces of Madoka Box, I just can't... I wish I remembered all of it. Like, I only can remember three of the, I want to say, 5 successors. I apparently forgot one of the suitors for Jet Black. I'm okay forgetting Unknown Shiranui Arc, that one's fine. I remember all the arcs at least. Wait, is that the father of the guy who working at the clothing store? Crowkleys? Crowkleys? Yeah, sure. I'm just gonna skip the G. Just look at that sad face. You made her sad. Once again, trying real hard. I'm just thinking about good parts of Madoka Box, and like, one thing that was good about the successor arc was the bladed boomerang, and everything that happened right around there. We got a really cool weapon. We got some great character progression, or character development. That's the word. All the things you need. And yeah, I'm still working to find the other 2 successors, and it's just not coming. Because it's Shori Wanizuka, the girl who always spoke like 2 opposite sentences and one was always crossed out. Don't know how that would ever be animated. Was one of them just kind of a gamer? Is that one of the ones I'm missing? And then there's also the magical girl one. Five sounds like the number of... 5 feels right. I don't want to say sounds, because, you know, once again, haven't read it in years. Just because 3/4 of you think that something isn't important doesn't mean that a robot exploding is not a bad thing. So I'm assuming the Sisters Project is the fact that is what made Rune and everyone else, and that there's somewhere between clones, golems, robots, Kanji style is the one where you can rearrange the radicals, right? Yeah. Now, is that the one who the person... Was that... If you can check who used that, is that the one who looks like a mechanic, or is that the one who they fought on the plane? I know that's quite possibly the worst way of describing the two characters, but that's truly all I remember about them. Okay, the Kanji one is the plain one. Okay. So then which... Then I'm missing one of... So I think I don't remember what label does. I'm not gonna bother scrolling up to find that. I'm just gonna look it up afterwards. Yeah, so let me finish this event and then we can head out. Or I can just talk about Madoka Box while looking at Rune for, like, another 15 minutes. What did the mechanic lady have, then? I think Label's the only one that I don't think we have on anyone. Unless she was 800 lives and just decided to... And was just like, yeah, I don't want to fight. Or unless Mechanic Lady's also the one who fought on the plane, but I'm fairly certain that's wrong. Mogara Kugurugi. That doesn't help. Miss conversion. Okay. That's the one where... hold on. That's the homonyms one, right? I forget which way it works, though. Is it... It sounds the same, so you can swap out the kanji to do something else? Homophone. Yeah, okay, yeah. You can use the hiragana to do different kanji. Okay, yeah, so... Cool, okay, good. I... Honestly, don't... I'm gonna read that, but... Yeah... It's so funny. those were probably the two best style users, because they're absolute mad. Nisio Ishin's an absolute mad lad for writing those abilities and, like, an entire fight around those. Alright, what is the name of the ability that current person had? Is that Label? That you just get to seal people? It's one of the other suitors. It's the girl that they played Shuritori against. I mean, it was four people, so... the one who sealed the people in the cards. Which ability is the one that one of them used to put Anshinin, Kumagawa, and at least... I think Zenkichi, Shira, Nui, Mogana... the vice or the general affairs manager that they added in after the successor arc. How many cards? There are 7 cards if I'm counting right, but yeah. Yes, but there were 4 people in that fight, remember? It was circular style with 4 players. If I remember correctly, it's the very small girl compared to the rest of them. I think it was the nurse. The card girl, or the Kotobuki card girl. Was it? Well, out of those 4, it would have to have been Momo. Were those the 4 people who played? I could have sworn it was at least 2 of the suitors playing. And I could have sworn Anshinin was sealed. Though I think Anshinin also was just like, okay, thank you. Anshinin was like, yeah, I'm sealed, but I'm so practiced being sealed that I just kind of jumped out of the card. Yeah, that's what I... So is Momo the card girl, or is she one of the other suitors that was trapped? Or is she general affairs girl that I forgot about? I don't think so, because I don't think her name was as funny as... Momo is card girl. Cool. And which style is that? By process of elimination, I went with Label, but yeah. I was just thinking about how the delete Shiratori went, like, that was such a good, like, I don't know what to call it, like, sub-arc. It was such a good part of the Jet Black Bride arc. Like, the whole thing was pretty good. This is a very good sentence on screen. Despite that you know what a crime is, you yet still committed crime. So if they're 6, then I think I know what it was. The 800, I think the Miyatani user copied 800 Lies and then continued to use Miyatani on some of the lies to duplicate some other people's abilities. I think that's how, and that one, the stalling tactic, worked. Yo, hey. Would you like to kill your master? Stop having no emotions. If you smile in front of me again, I am going ballistic. All right, with that, that's a good time to stop. All right. So we got some good progress done on that. We're about halfway done. Definitely could finish this in probably... Yeah, so I'd say this is probably a 5-hour game if I was actually, like, reading it the whole time. Okay, cool, the music still plays. All right, as I try to find us a, someone to raid out to, I will stop talking about Madoka Box for, like, couple minutes at least. Thank you. I'm me talking about it for an hour and a half, or the fact that you, or the VN that I've been playing behind it. Sorry, that's just very funny to me. So if you enjoy my stream, which I the VN. Well, I'm glad. It's about 5 hours. task failed successfully. I got Z interested in a VN by talking about Madoka Box for an hour and a half while incredibly slowly going through a VN. So anyone who was watching could, like, actually read it for once. But yeah, thanks everyone for watching. Thank you. I hope me talking about it for an hour and a half at least convince you that somebody likes it. Yeah, I know where we're going. But yeah, so thank you all for watching. I had a blast, and it was only partially because I spent so much time talking about Madoka Box. It was because you were here and allowed me to do so. Big thanks to Toki for just being on the wiki and allowing me to bounce information off of you. Yeah, so I stream twice a week. I know the two people here definitely know that. Wednesdays and Saturdays, 2 p.m. EST to 6 p.m. on Wednesday. That's going to be Tales of Berseria into some random game from my Steam library that is not a visual novel, because that is what I spend my Saturdays doing, which is midnight to 2 p.m. EST. And, is there anything else I gotta say? No. So let me push that raid button as I thank you all. We'll be going to Penlock Holmes, who is playing Danganronpa 2, because I sure do love Danganronpa, even though Danganronpa 2 is the only one that I have absolutely no knowledge of, besides the characters who were in Danganronpa 3, Despair Side. I was trying to remember which one was which. Because there are three Danganronpa... Well, four Danganronpa 3s. There is... Danganronpa 3, Despair. Danganronpa 3, Future. Danganronpa 3, Hope. And then Danganronpa V3. The V stands for version, and it means it's the third game. Well, Danganronpa 3, all of those first three ones weren't actually ever games. But not to just randomly drop more information on you because I like talking about things that I enjoy. Yeah, go say hi to Penlock. If you want to be dropped into the middle of a mystery game that I do actually plan on playing at some point, and maybe be spoiled on something, like I might be, you can chill in there for a bit. Otherwise, just say hi. I like Penlock. She's nice. She's got some funny catchphrases, is the best I can call it. But once again, thank you all for being here. I had a good time with y'all. Only reason I can have so much fun here is because you guys are here. So, with that, I thank you all, and goodbye.